Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to customize the dropdown list items, values, header, and footer using templates. Let's move on to the coding part. I will open my existing application, which already has the Syncfusion React Dropdowns package installed. On the app.tsx page, I have included the basic dropdown list rendering code. If you need to know how to create a basic React dropdown list, you can refer to my Getting Started video link in the card above or in the description below. With this code, you can visualize the employee list. Let's take a quick look at the data I have bound to the data source property of the dropdown list. Also map the name field to the text property and employee ID to the value property in the field settings. Let me run this application and show you the output. Look at the dropdown list. When I click the dropdown icon, an employee list is displayed. First, I'll show you how to customize the dropdown list items using the item template property. I declare a method, customItems, and design the template items with images. Include the image tag with the class name employeeImage and provide the source from Syncfusion demo images. Then add content division elements and display the employee name and job accessing the details from the props variable. Add the class names to align these elements. I open the app.css page and define the styles for image, name, and job. Assign this method to the item template property. Look at the dropdown list now. Image, name, and designation have been added to each list item. Now, I will show you how to customize the dropdown list value using the value template property. I copy and paste this method, change its name to custom values, and remove the designation alone. Change the class name for image and name element. In the app.css page, define the styles for image and selected value. I assign this method to the value template property. Also set the image height and width to 28 pixels. See now, when I select any value, the dropdown list displays the custom template value. I can also customize the pop-up header using the header template property. I create another method, custom header. Then in the template design, I show the header texts as photo and employee information. I assign class name, header to this element and column header to this. Then I define the CSS styles. Then assign this method to the header template property. See here, the dropdown header has been customized based on the template. I can also customize the footer using the footer template property. I create another method, custom footer. Then in the template design, we'll add custom text, like add new item. Also, I will show the plus icon by adding span element with the class name e-icons+. In the app.css page, I specify the content for the plus symbol. Then assign this method to the footer template property. I assign class name footer to this element. Check now, the dropdown pop-up list has a footer based on the provided template. Finally, I will show you how to customize the no record content using the no records template property. I have already added an empty JSON object in the data.js file. Import that data and use it in the data source property. See now, the pop-up list displays no records are found. To change the default content, include no records template property and provide the content as no record available. Look now, the provide custom content is displayed instead of default one. Let me recap what we have seen so far. I showed you how to customize the drop-down list items, values, header, and footer using templates. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.